Hey guys, Seriously Smalls here. Today I am going to try my first attempt ever of paint pouring on a rock. Before I get started though, you will hear George Strait in the background. I do not own any rights to his music, but I absolutely love him and music helps me be calm. And since I'm a little nervous about how this is going to go, I thought I would include some of my George for luck. You will notice on the screen right now, I have all of my supplies out. I'll go over them in detail, but I just have a cheap pizza tray, a cooling rack that I got at the dollar store. It was only a dollar, of course, but with that, it's a little cheap. So the bigger the rocks, they kind of, you know, push down. I'm not too concerned right now. This is my first one. We'll see how it goes. I have my paints, a small paper cup, and then a paintbrush because I'm also going to attempt to do a transfer. So with that being said, I will show you the paints I'm using as well as the rock. I've chosen to do Apple Barrel paint as well as Folk Art glitter. The Apple Barrel I will be using is Cardinal Crimson White Pink Parfait, and then with the Folk Art Extreme Glitter, I have Jelly Bean Pink and Hologram. And so I'm going to layer them and I will show you that. So here on the table, you can see I have my rock that I'm gonna do the pouring on. It is like heart shaped, so I'm very excited. It's very, very heavy. And then I have a smaller rock that I am going to attempt to do the transfer on. So once I get my paint poured for you to see, I will put the rock into focus a little bit more. So I'm gonna take my cup, and first I need to decide how do I wanna layer the colors. So I think I am gonna start with some red. I have already shook them up pretty good, so all I'm gonna do is squeeze, maybe. Sorry, the arthritis. Squeeze some in. And then I think I'm gonna go ahead and do a little bit of the plain pink. Because remember, you're gonna have to do tons and tons of this layering. It does require a lot of paint. And so that's why I'm attempting to do the transfer afterwards, so that way I'm not wasting as much, because the paint can get very, very expensive. I did get the Apple Barrel paints. They had a, I guess you could say it was like a sale at Walmart where you could get 12 colors. They were already pre-packaged and they were selling for $4.99. And so I figured just to first try it out and everything, that would be perfect. So in just a second, I will show you my cup. But since this is such a big rock, I am gonna be needing a lot of paint. So when I've been putting this paint in, I literally have just been doing it at different angles. Some of it is actually overlapping, some has touched the side of the cup. You know, it's just gonna be however I decide to squirt it in. I'm really excited to see the glitter. I will say the glitter paint I did get also at Walmart, and it was a little pricier. It was $2 for a 2-ounce bottle. So I will not be going as crazy because being medically retired from teaching, I am on a very limited budget. Okay, so I don't even know if this is enough paint that I have put in here. I have filled it up about halfway. And we're gonna see what happens. I might go ahead and add a little more of the non-glitter because that was less expensive. I really hope that the music is not too loud, since I will not be able to redo this for you guys. So here we go, let's see. I'm gonna throw a little more sparkle on the very top. Okay. So now I will say I am right-handed. So in order to do this on the camera, you might not be able to see it. I am going to try my absolute best. Oh, look, I have got paint all over my table. So there you go. I just didn't want to waste it. All right, so I'm going to put this about there. And like I stated earlier, we are going to squeeze the cup like this. So I'm going to go ahead and try this left-handed for you guys. And the best thing that I have observed from watching tons of videos is you just go and you just start, you just kind of swirl it. And I'm noticing I might be needing more paint than what I've expected. So if that's the case, not a big deal. Now you'll notice right now I am not going in any particular pattern, okay? Some videos I'm gonna have to make some more mixture here, which is okay, because you still have the... So some videos I have seen where people go and they'll mix things into their paint to make it a little more fluid, which I might have to do. I may have learned that going straight with the paint was, you know, too much. And if that's the case, no big deal. Live and learn, right? It's quite all right. This is another reason why I only had two rocks set up today to do, instead of trying to do a bunch in case I did not like the way I was doing this. So I'm gonna kind of take, and I'm trying to kind of do in between. You can see that I am by no means a pro at this. I can easily see why they suggest mixing that little bit of a thinner that they have in it, because that would make it a lot easier, I would honestly think, because then you could, it would smooth a little bit more. I feel like, in all honesty, I've used half a container of paint already. Now, I have not used as much of the glitter, because see, you can see it's a little thick coming out, which is okay. Now, I was watching one video where a lady suggested adding just a little bit of water to each of the paint colors you're going to use before using them. So, I think that might be a good suggestion for next time as well. I'm gonna kind of roll this over a little bit and see where I maybe need to fill in. It looks like I need to try to get some, I don't know if I can get any more squeezed out of this cup. Kind of right there. You will see it will drip. It is eventually, I mean, it will drip. It's gonna take it a little while. But it is going to drip. And I just made that one line going the opposite direction, so that might be a little interesting. I'm looking at my other side here, because that's one thing I have learned, though, that you want it all at once. You don't want to come back. I mean, I guess you could come back with different colors later, but that made a really pretty, but see, I still have that gap right there. So what I'm gonna do is open up my little cup because I don't want to waste, you know, there's still paint in there. I just have to get it out. And I think I'm going to go with some more red and maybe go ahead and throw in a little bit of the white sparkle and let's see what I can. I apologize that this video is so long, guys. Like I said, this is my very first attempt. So, you know, sometimes you don't know what you're doing your first time around. I think it's truly getting better. You can see even there on that front. I'm going to try to put a blob squeezed out from the cup. I think it's going to have a very pretty color to it. I will say right now, I'm not really seeing the sparkles that I put in, but that's okay. I have one little empty spot. You can kind of see it right there that somehow it got skipped over. So I'm just going to put a blob. And I know people are thinking, why would you do that? You just ruined it. But there are a couple little open areas of my rock. And you know what? I believe you have to learn. You learn by doing. That's the teacher in me. You truly learn by doing. And I'm okay with that. I will say, be sure to cover your work area because I have totally 100% made a mess of my table here. So what I'm going to do, even though I'm going to attempt to transfer, I am going to just try to squeeze out whatever is possibly left in this paper cup on my transfer rock. And really, there wasn't much at all. Okay, so what you're supposed to do then is you take a brush, and I have this size, and you pick up this paint underneath. So you just kind of pick it up, and then you just put it on. Because this way, you're not wasting this paint down here. Because, like I said earlier, paint can get very expensive. And so, if you can reuse it, then you might as well. So all I'm doing, I'll see if I can turn this, is I have just gone and I am picking up chunks of the paint and just kind of dropping it, smearing it on. Now, I'm not completely rubbing it like you would a normal paintbrush because I don't want it all to blend together. But I literally, you can see, I'm just getting the paint off the brush and letting it do its own thing. Now, I will say the problem I am experiencing right now, because I went with the cheaper baking cooling rack, is it's been a little more difficult to get the paint out from underneath. But that could also be because I chose such a heavy rock. Now, eventually, all this paint is supposed to go and kind of drip off the edges. See, I got some more white right there, so I'm going to kind of, I'm trying to just kind of check, since this is not as much paint, make sure I have at least the edges done.
Wash your man one,
If you can see me, this is my crafting face. I did not do my hair or anything because I wasn't planning on being on camera. So I'm kind of looking right now. I see a variety of colors and textures, and you can see that my heart there, it's starting to drip even. And that's okay, because that's ultimately what we want. There's a little spot right there. I'm gonna probably do a no-no and do that because I'm OCD. And so I'm actually gonna take that little bit that was dripping and I'm gonna place it on the rock over here that I have. I will do a picture and everything to show you guys, and then of course I will update it once it's nice and dry. I will show you what it has come out to look like. I apologize if this is super long. Like I said, this was my very first try, so I wanted to kind of show you guys that anybody can, you know, try. It's okay. And that's about it. Seriously, just give it a try. It's not gonna hurt, and good luck.